I will show you how to write PrestaShop code. I seen many people who are very confused about writing PrestaShop code. They find it very difficult for themselves to write PrestaShop code. But in this article, you can easily learn how to write PrestaShop code. If you are interested in becoming a PrestaShop developer just like me, you can come to my website and view this article, how to write PrestaShop code, and I have explained how PrestaShop code works. I'll explain you the basics about. You can find other similar articles on my website, joelwebsites.com. Okay, so I will dive in how to write a PrestaShop code. Okay, so 1 minute. So the things that you need to know while writing PrestaShop code. First of all, PrestaShop works in using this Smarty template engine. You can come to smarty.net and here you can come and find the the code that you want. For example, you can just click on the search box and you can type, suppose if you want a date related code, date. Suppose if you want to insert the date inside the form, inside PrestaShop. Okay, so here you'll get some results and you can use this code inside the date. So suppose if you write date this thing on your template, you will get an output saying 14 Jan. Okay, so this might sound a bit confusing in the start, but it is very easy. You just need to know what is a template, what is if you see my other video, you will understand what is a template, what is a controller and what is a module. PrestaShop works in the technology of model view controller, so it is very important that you understand what is a module and what is a view and what is a controller. So PrestaShop is a super e-commerce software. It is used for shopping businesses. Okay, so suppose I'll give you another example. Suppose if you want to create a form, sorry, if you want to create a grid, you can try searching for grid. Search results for grid. Let's see if I've got anything. No. But okay. So you can try changing the keyword. Suppose if grid is not there, you can you say retrieve data. Okay, there you go. Okay, so for retrieving data in PHP, we generally use a for each loop, correct? But in Smarty framework, we also use a for each loop, but this is slightly different than what then it is slightly different from the way we implement it. See, see, okay. So now, suppose if you want to write some code in PrestaShop displaying a form of data for each user from the database, you want to display this data from the database. Okay, so you will have to connect in the module, in the controller. You will have to write the execution code for the query. So this will be the execution code. Select star from users. then you will have to just assign the array with res. Res is where you will have to write the with a query as well as the PrestaShop function is stored. In PrestaShop you will see a different function here. I mean you will see a different function here. The syntax won't be exactly the same, but if you want to study the syntax for PrestaShop, you there are very slight changes in the spellings, and you will and while practicing. I'll show you one second. Let me browse to the folder. So now your question might be, where do we get the syntax? If you don't, if you're not getting the syntax at smarty.com or smarty.net, you can come to the your PrestaShop installation folder, that is htdocs PrestaShop modules. Inside this you can open any one. You can keep finding for the correct syntaxes. You can open a file. Let's say now for this I have opened a block my account. This is a my account module. Okay, so now to understand the syntax of for PrestaShop, you will now need to just see here db get instance execute. This is how they execute a query in PrestaShop. Whereas now if you see the same thing in wherever it's written execute, they are putting res in this. It is slightly different. In PrestaShop there are you can write execute as. Suppose if you're selecting star if you're selecting for data from the database, you can write execute. You have to write execute as in PrestaShop. Otherwise if you are inserting data in this query, you must write execute. Okay, I'll try to find another example where you'll easily find out. And one more thing I want to know, let you know about a new resource that PrestaShop is offering. PrestaShop test. This is a test. I hope I get it online on Google. I will share the URL for testing the module. If you go to prestashop.com, if you go to the prestashopaddons.com, I hope. So, if you want to match the syntax exactly like the PrestaShop one. If you want to make your syntax match the PrestaShop standards, you'll have to log in here. You can create your account also. Okay, so after you register here, you will able to even there is a section where you can test the module. Before you upload the module, PrestaShop checks the module. If it is PrestaShop checks your module whether it is compatible with PrestaShop. So, yeah, there are some tips and guidance that you will get. This guidance will lead you to the PrestaShop documentation in their website. Okay, so yeah, how I'll explain how it generally works, the testing thing. You have to upload your model and then it will show you a list of all the possible errors in your PrestaShop model, and then you have to just solve these errors. They will even give you suggestions about what changes have to be made. So it will be very easy for you. So as for today, my suggestion is that you go to smarty.net, and here you can just follow the tutorials, and then accordingly you will understand PrestaShop how it works, and then you will find it 100 times easier to write a PrestaShop module. Thank you guys for watching my video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll be coming up with many more videos. Thank you.